At this point, you've probably already successfully displayed objects in a table view in previous apps that you've built. Thanks to the Table View Data Source protocol, it's pretty easy. Just answer the questions that the table view throws at you, such as how many sections, rows per section, etc., and you're done. We've done this before. So, what is new about using core data objects? Well, the advancement is that NSFetch Results Controller can answer all those questions posed by the data source. We're going to use a subclass of UI Table View Controller that receives an NSFetch Results Controller and then lets it handle almost all of the questions from the table view. Let's first take a look at Core Data Table View Controller. This is the class that all our table view controllers will inherit from. It takes an NSFetch Results Controller and lets it do all or almost all the talking. The only method from the data source protocol that it cannot implement for us is cell for row at index path. The reason for this is that it cannot know what type of cell you want. So this is the only method that you will have to always implement. This is a good place for you to pause and check out the code for this class, which is linked in the companion text. We'll be using it in the next video.